Hello there, welcome to this video. Let's see, all you need to start quickly and easily with Autodesk AutoCAD 2016. Leave us comments to improve our future guides. AutoCAD is one of the best softwares used for CAD designs and architectural projects in both 2D and 3D. When you open it, you will be directed to the Start tab, divided in two sections. In Learn, you find tips and tutorials to discover AutoCAD. In Create, you manage new and old projects made, or open sample ones available. You can open projects done through Open Files, or create new ones going on Start Drawing, or simply clicking on the plus tab on top. Let's see the workspace. We will use the default one that AutoCAD uses. On top, you have a full list of tools and buttons ready to use to work. Then you have the main workspace where you draw, and more at the bottom, you have the command line and some quick buttons that set important drawing settings. If you need more room, you can click on the small icon above to reduce all panels' sizes. Let's see how to draw objects. All the main important tools are inside the Home section. Moreover, if you hover on a button for some time, a detailed explanation will appear, showing you green numbered steps to follow or guided interactive videos. There are also buttons that do include more than one feature inside. These do show a white arrow close to them, so that you can decide which feature to use. You can use line or polyline to draw simple segments. Use Escape key to stop drawing. Use Circle to draw a circle, fixing two points by clicking on the workspace. Three-point arc draws an arc by fixing 3 points instead. AutoCAD always shows you a rough preview of what you are doing. The object is created when you finish the last step. Inside the white arrow, you can change the way to draw arcs or circles. So if you choose Start Center Angle Arc, you fix 2 points and then the angle to draw an arc, instead of fixing 3 points as before. You can also draw polygons and ellipses. Check the smaller icons. Depending on what you choose, you will need to fix points, angles, or lengths, so do hover buttons if you need some help at drawing each object. The buttons in the bottom right corner are used to adjust all your drawing settings. All settings active are shown in blue. Use grid mode to turn on or off the grid on your workspace. Use snap mode to enable or disable snappings to all the grid points shown. Use Ortho mode to draw following just the X horizontal direction or the Y vertical direction. Very important is the object snap command. While you draw in your workspace, AutoCAD helps you being precise using snappings. When you get close to key points, like vertices, intersections, midpoints, and so on, your pointer will directly snap to them. So endpoints and vertices are represented by green squares, intersections by green crosses, centers by green circles, midpoints by green triangles, and directions with green dashed lines. If you want to draw completely freely, turn off Object Snap clicking on the O Snap button. If you click on the white arrow on the right, you can disable snappings on some key points and consider more additional key points, like tangents, perpendicular directions, or geometrical centers. A new feature that shows you the center of any closed path through a white asterisk. When you finish drawing, you need to enable the tool again to draw the same object, or simply use Enter key directly. While you draw, you can undo all using Escape key. When you have no drawing tools active, you are in selection mode. Your pointer does not draw new objects, but interacts with objects to edit and manage them. When you hover on an object, this is highlighted, and a dialog box appears giving you information about the kind of such object, its style and its layer. Layers are very important to manage complex projects. Check out our video in this guide for more about this. But if you click on the object, you will select it, and this will be highlighted in blue. You can personalize any object selected going on Properties on top, changing color, line style, line thickness and transparency. Undo any selection done by using Escape key. If you want to manage more objects at the same time, you can select them one by one, clicking on each single object. A small plus sign will appear next to your pointer. If you hold Shift down and click, you can deselect an object from your overall selection. In this case, you have a minus sign on your pointer. You can also use the lasso selection to select objects faster. Just click and hold your click down to create a selection area. If you drag from the left to the right, you will create a blue area called the window lasso that selects just all objects fully contained inside such. If you drag from the right to the left, you will use a crossing lasso that selects also all objects that are even partially included. In this case, the area is in green color. Always use Escape key to undo all selections. Once an object or objects is selected, you can start editing it. To delete it, use Delete key. To cut, copy and paste, use Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C, and Ctrl and V. While pasting, check the preview and click to place the copy. A selected object has also some blue nodes used for editing. To move lines, circles, and arcs, you can simply click and drag from their central point. To edit their shape or length, you can drag from the other nodes. Always check the preview while doing so. Plus, if you hover any blue node, critical lengths and angles are shown, and a dialog box appears, making you choose between stretch and lengthen. The first one edits the shape without any limitation, while lengthen lets you edit without changing the basic shape of the object, so keeping the direction for the line or the radius for the arc. Rectangles, polygons, and polylines behave differently. Here you have big and smaller blue nodes. Hover on the big ones set on the vertices. You can move them through stretch vertex, or add or remove ones going on add or remove vertex. The smaller ones do set the sides of the polygon. For example, use Convert to Arc to set curves, or Stretch to Skew. In this case, you can't move the object directly from the nodes. You need to use, in this case, the move command. Select the object and enable the move command from the modify section. Then simply click and drag. If you enable the move command and you have a small square as a pointer, it means that you don't have a selected object yet. Simply select all objects you need to move and then use Enter to start editing. In case you want to make more complex editing on a single object or on more objects at the same time, you need to use the tools in Modify section. These do work exactly as seen for the Move command. For example, you can use Rotate to rotate the selected object. Scale to scale without deforming the object. Just type the scale factor and use Enter to apply it. AutoCAD is not made of buttons only. You can also use the command line to search, follow, and personalize any action you want to perform. For example, while you draw, you can use your down arrow key to choose in a list of sub-options and then use Enter to apply. If you are drawing a polyline, you can directly draw arcs if you choose arc in the list. If you are drawing a rectangle, you can draw it, fixing its area with area, or fixing length and width with dimensions. The list inside does depend on the tool you are using and on which step you are. You can also use the main command line at the very bottom. If you type inside, a list of all matching commands appears. For example, if you type and choose rectangle, you will activate the rectangle tool. You will see that the command line shows you all sub-options to change the way to draw it, just as we have seen before with the dialog box close to your pointer. You can type the blue letter on the box to choose what you need and use Enter key to apply. Even more, while you draw, AutoCAD shows you the exact measurement of any length and angle related to the object in preview. You can define measurements either using your pointer or typing directly from your keyboard. Use Enter to apply. The measurement unit used is decimal by default. You can change its format going on customization and then to units. To manage your actions done, you can use the undo and redo arrows in the very top left corner to enable your latest tools used. Instead, browse by using your up arrow key. Checking your project is also very important. You can zoom in and out around your pointer using your mouse wheel. Enable the pen tool on the extreme right and click and drag to check around. Use Escape to finish. You can also use the 3D view cube in the top right corner. In case of 2D projects, you will see just the top face. You can rotate using the hidden arrows in a corner or dragging from the circle left or right. On the project, there is also a default object representing the Cartesian system. In 2D, you have the x-axis, representing the horizontal direction in red, and the y-axis, representing the vertical direction in green. You can move it by dragging from its center and rotating 2D, dragging the rounded nodes. If you rotate the axis, also the cube on the corner and the workspace grid will follow. Once you have finished, save your project. Go to the AutoCAD icon and go to Save As. AutoCAD projects are saved as .dwg, and this lets you edit and modify all again later. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our full guide to learn much more about AutoCAD 2016.